Hi friends, today we are discussing about Essential Commodities Act of 1955. So you may be curious in that aspect, why 1955 Act must be discussed for 2020 exams. This act actually is being discussed and debated in recent past for multiple reasons. So what is actually the core of Essential Commodities Act is, this act permits the government to regulate the production, storage and supply of a list of commodities which the government from time to time declare as essential commodities. So any commodity based on the requirement, demand or shortage of supply can be introduced into this particular act, then it will be called as an essential commodity, and the government will on that very next moment will get a control over the production, distribution and supply of this particular commodity. So this act is actually something which has empowered our government to control and regulate our markets. Even in our day-to-day life, this act is having a reflection. For example, a packaged good, the MRP of a packaged good is fixed based on Essential Commodities Act. If it is included in Essential Commodities list schedule, then the MRP of that product can be regulated by the central government. So here, this act is actually having a day-to-day significance for us. Now, why this is being discussed? There is acrimonious debate being going on based on the outdated nature of this particular act. Because this was formed in 1955, as we said earlier, where the transportation facility, the integrated nature of our supply side constraints, logistics issues, all these issues were prevailing during those times. So based on that, there was a problem that if there is a production shock in any part of the country, that can result in hoarding and black marketing of a commodity. To deal with this situation, in 1950s, we actually introduced this particular act. And now what are the problems associated with act in the recent past? Most important aspect is, as majority of our products, especially pulses, edible oils, petroleum and petroleum products, fertilizers, all these commodities are typically included in this particular act. All these things are produced, many of these things are produced seasonally, which means there is need of large scale storage to ensure round the clock supply of these particular products. To ensure that, this law may be a barrier in many instances for stocking this in large quantities. Second thing, most important aspect where India is lagging behind is storage facilities. Even the best producing state in India can't store its food grains even for 70 days. That is the situation in India. And why we are not investing more in this kind of stocking and this kind of warehousing is because of Essential Commodities Maintenance Act. Because permissions, licenses, etc. is required in that regard. Third thing is, most important area where India can develop its facility is food processing industry. It can be considered as a buffer stage where an agrarian economy, that kind of India, can be transformed into a secondary manufacturing economy, where we need a buffer stage which is called food processing. Food processing is actually a buffer stage. Here, we need round-the-clock supply of products, which means there must be storage of these products. There must be cold storages, warehouses, all these things are required for food processing industry. There also, Essential Commodities Act is actually creating a barrier in investment in that area also. So these are the problems associated with this particular law as of now. So we are now this law is being considered, and I think sooner or later we will restructure this entire law to facilitate the economy of this country. Thank you.